This part of the series is going to be about patents, and it's really for Australia. I've just basically done my first take on that. I wasn't exactly planning to say anything, and I lost the sound due to problem with the software. It's something to do with GDK, record my desktop and the way it's handling compression. But anyway, I will do a second take on that now by trying to explain my first experiences with software patents and the reason I quite hate them. So software patents were sort of introduced to me as a concept way back in 2005 or maybe 4. I was very active in the pub news groups. I was trying to provide help to people who were struggling with their PDA, basically. And the one of the things which occurred to me at the time was that Xerox had had a lawsuit against Palm, when Palm was an independent company before it became part of HP. So Palm basically had to remove a feature which was called Graffiti, and replace it eventually with Graffiti 2. Now, Graffiti is a sort of language or a method for encoding or decoding a stroke from a stylus or a servo fan from a user of a computer, a small computer that has a touchscreen, a sensitive screen, to get out of that a digit or a character or a symbol or something of that sort based on the wrong stroke that's going to span a certain trajectory in 2D space. Okay, so for each letter that you have in the alphabet, you're supposed to have a certain symbol or a certain vector that represents its existence there. So if I want to put in a word that says A, B, and C, the A is going to look more like a triangle, and the B is just going to be one stroke with two kind of twirly line. It really has to be visualized to be understood. But in any case, the patent itself was a monopoly for Xerox on the notion of using the one stroke or a certain language of strokes to represent the letters. Palm then had to move to Graffiti 2. Now, Graffiti 2 was a language similar to that, but basically requiring two strokes. Okay, so that would sort of avoid and evade the patent. What Palm had to do then is to pass to me as a user, as a customer, to the inconvenience of having to change the language, to change the way that I wrote my words and expressed myself and actually put input into the device. And all of this because of patents, basically, software patents or an actual software implemented approach to encoding the things on the string. So here I was, not as a developer in this case. I was a developer, but not a developer for Palm, but I was as a consumer losing the functionality on my device. And I wrote about it at the time, but I wasn't quite so keen on the notion of, you know, trying to spend a lot of many years fighting against software patents. That actually happened later when I started to criticize, even way back in 2007, notions like intellectual property, which means that the idea that you can encode letters in strokes, you know, that could be like a monopoly of yours and a so-called property of yours and something that's an intellectual thing, even though any kid can think of it, maybe not implement this, but actually think of the idea of doing so. And Palm, of course, was not sued over copyrights, it was sued over patents. So